हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेरी वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। इट इज़ द क्लास ऑफ 12th क्लास। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर स्टडिंग ए वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट चैप्टर विच इज़ इम्पॉर्टेंट नॉट ओनली फॉर नॉलेज बट फॉर द एग्जामिनेशन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू ऑल्सो। We studied three parts of the lesson, women's education, and now we are going to study the fifth part of this chapter. This part is going to start from the line, "There is a famous verse dot dot go my dear." I am going to start the explanation, the English explanation of this chapter. You know very well that whenever we have to explain in English of any paragraph or stanza, first of all we write reference, then context, and then explanation. You know very well that in reference we write the chapter name and the name of the writer or poet, and in context we write about which the paragraph or the stanza is being explained or is being described. So in this paragraph the writer is telling the other theme of this chapter. I am going to start now. "There is a famous verse which tells us samsara visvrikshasya." It means to say, the writer says that in English, in Sanskrit slok, it is said that this world is not perfect. This world is just like a tree which is full of troubles and problems. Means there are many, many lacks in this world. This world is not perfect. In this perfect world, samsara, there are two fruits of inimitable quality. They are the study of our great classics and communion with great minds. Means the writer is saying, the writer S. Radhakrishnan is saying that in this world there are two fruits, and these two fruits have matchless quality, inimitable quality, and these fruits are very, very important for human being. What is the fruits? The first fruit is the study of our great books, our ancient books. Means, for example, Gita, Upanishad, Puran, etc., Ramayana, Mahabharata, etc., and communion with great men. It means we should have a company, we must have a company with those persons who have the knowledge of these ancient classics or books. Means we can find, we can get many persons who have the knowledge of, we have the very well knowledge of the Ramayana, of the Gita, of the Upanishada, of the Purana, or other religious books. First of all, we should study these books, and if we are unable to read these books, we must have a company with those persons who have the knowledge of these religious books, just like Ramayana, Gita, Mahabharata, Upanishada, etc. These two are the things which mold men's minds, hearts. It means to say, we are human being, we have sense, we have knowledge, we have feeling, we understand good or bad, religious or irreligious. So The atmosphere affects our mind and heart. It is very, very important to know that the atmosphere directly affects on the minds and the hearts of a children and person. It means to say, if we are living in a very bad company, the badness will affect our mind and heart. And if we are living in a good company, in a very good company, this good company, the goodness of this company will affect our mind. You know very well, in Hindi it is said, kusangati ka jwar bada bhayanak hota hai. You know that bad friendship have a very bad effect on our mind. It means to say, if we study these religious books, the goodness, the wellness, the religious things of these books will have a very soothing effect, will have a very great effect on our mind and on our heart. Suppose that we are studying Ramayana, goodness is everywhere and badness is everywhere. Good things everywhere and bad things are everywhere. We have to choose what things feel good to us. If we like good things, we will search good things and we will follow good things. And if we like bad things, we will find bad things. So we know very well that these religious books, just like Ramayana, Gita, Upanishad, Purana, have, or you can say, they are full of religious things, religious teachings, religious lessons, religious educations for our life, for our society and for our country. We will read, we will study, and we will find good education from those books, and we will learn many things, we will follow many things that will be very, very beneficial in our lives. I would like to tell you that in this presentation, dharma is very, very important. But we are following our religion only for soul. We are not following. It is my opinion, but we are not following our religion in real sense. We go to temples, we go to masjid, we go to church, and our religion only for those places. But when we come in the society, in the family, we forget those religions. Further, I would like to read the line. I am anxious that our great classics should be studied, the classics of all countries of which we are inheritors. Means our ancestors wrote these great books, and our ancestors, our forefathers followed these religious books. They lead their life on the basis of these great classics of Hindu culture, of Indian culture. So it is very, very important, it is very, very necessary that everyone should have the knowledge of these religious books. I do not mean to say that I am talking, or the writer is talking only about Hindu culture, but for every culture, for every religion. Either it is Hindu culture, either it is a Muslim religion, either it is a Christian religion or other religion. He is talking about every religion. Means our ancestors, our forefathers gave us these religious books, and they followed, they led their life, they passed their life on the basis of these religious books. So we must study these religious books, because these are the responsibility of us, which have been given by our ancestors, forefathers to us. Further, next line, it is in a small dialogue in an Upanishad that a question is put, what constitutes the essence of good life? The teacher replies, did not you hear the answer? There was a thunderclap. Immediately the teacher explained
दैट दीज वेयर द एसेंस ऑफ गुड लाइफ दम दान दया दे कॉन्स्टिट्यूट द एसेंशियल्स ऑफ गुड लाइफ यू मस्ट हैव दम दैट इज सेल्फ कंट्रोल रेस्ट्रेंट विच इज द मार्क ऑफ ह्यूमन बीइंग मीन्स हियर द राइटर राधाकृष्णन tells us about a dialogue which has come from our religious book from Hindu religious book which name is Upanishad. In Upanishad the teacher is talking someone you can say the teacher is talking his pupils his students someone asked the teacher what is the essence of good life means how can we make our life good how can we feel goodness happiness in our life it means what is the substance what is the philosophy of good life this is the question which is being asked in a dialogue in Upanishad then the teacher replies He tells his students that you must hear the thunderclap which is happening in the sky and this thunder clap gives us a sound which is telling da da and da first second and third means da sounds the letters da in hindi this is in hindi sounds three times in a thunderclap of the sky the teacher is saying that you must hear these three times words and you must follow them This da means dam in Hindi and in English self control you can say stamina means here what is self control how can we be self control how can we have self control means self controlled means self control means self discipline stamina means it means to say the writer the teacher wants to give a message to his students that you must be controlled minded you must be balanced minded you must have powers of mind you must have powers of body you must have powers of character and how can we make our life self controlled and self disciplined if we study the religious books if we live in good company if we live with those persons who have the knowledge of these religious books you will learn the lesson of self control you will learn the lesson of self discipline from these people or from these religious books it means suppose that a very difficult problem is coming before you and you are bothered you become restless it means you do not have self control but suppose a very difficult problem is coming before you and you first of all think then you try to solve your problem very easily by controlling your mind and by controlling yourself this is the very important quality means balanced mind self controlled self discipline is the first lesson of our life by which we can make our life good better best and full of happiness this is the first lesson and dan that is charity that is charity and the second is daya that is mercy means dam, dan, daya. These Hindi words, dam, dan, daya, are the essence of better life, are the essence, are the summary, are the philosophy of good life. Means dan, you know, charity. How can we donate something to others if we have money, if we are successful? And how can we be a successful person by the study, by hard work, by thinking, by self-control, by self-discipline? We can be a successful person having self-control, self-discipline and other things. And if we are self-controlled, we are successful. And if we are successful, we should have the quality of charity. We should donate something to the helpless people. This is the quality of human being. Means we must have mercy. If we are having mercy, if we are merciful, surely we will be a good donator. Surely our mind and heart will be full of charity. So these three things are the essence of good life. These three things, dam, dan, daya, self-control, restraint, good manner, charity and mercy, are the qualities which we should have. And by having these qualities, we can make our life better and better. They make our life, these three things make our life good, better and best, and we are happy in our life. We can be happy in our life. Further, the writer is changing his subject. Further, he says, the line is, in the Ramayana, when Lakshmana sets out for the forest, his mother tells him, look upon Rama as your father, Dasaratha. Look upon Sita as myself, as your mother. Look upon the forest as Ayodhya, go my dear. Means here, a very small incident, a very small happening is being drawn, is being presented before us from our religious book, the Ramayana. You know very well that in Ramayana, Rama, the great person, the great Hindu person, Sri Ramchandra, Purushottam Sri Ramchandra ji, was sent to the forest. When he was going to start his journey for the forest for 14 years, his mother, means the mother of Rama, advises Lakshmana, what? Look upon Rama as your father, Dasaratha. Means Kausalya ji is advising here Lakshman ji that he should think, that Lakshmana should think his elder brother Ramchandra as his father, Dasaratha. Means she is telling him that you should suppose that your big brother, your elder brother is just like your father Dasaratha. And your bhabhi, that is Sita, should be looked upon by you as your mother Kausalya. Means your bhabhi is just like your mother, and the whole forest is just like your kingdom, that is Ayodhya. This is a very good lesson for everybody. We are related to our hometown, we are related to our family, we are related to our family. And if we are leaving, we are giving up for some time, for some days, for some month, for some year, our family, and we are going out in other place, we will not be happy. But if we think that this is our brother and this is our society and this is our family everywhere, we will be very much happy. We will not feel unhappiness anywhere we are going. This is a very, very good lesson for us from this Ramayana. Means in Ramayana, in a very small incident,
कौसल्या जी द मदर ऑफ रामचंद्र जी लक्ष्मण जी एंड अदर ब्रदर्स इज एडवाइजिंग लक्ष्मण जी दैट ही शुड लुक हिज एल्डर ब्रदर एज हिज फादर दशरथ जी एंड ही शुड लुक हिज भाभी एज हिज मदर कौसल्या जी. दिस इज अ वेरी गुड लेसन. नाउ आई एम क्लोजिंग हियर द फोर्थ पार्ट एंड आई थिंक इन द फिफ्थ पार्ट आई वुड क्लोज दिस आई विल विंड इंड दिस चैप्टर. सो इन दिस चैप्टर इन दिस पैराग्राफ वी शुड मेनी थिंग्स यू शुड हियर यू शुड लिसन टू दिस पैराग्राफ मेनी टाइम्स फॉर ए बेटर अंडरस्टैंडिंग. थैंक यू वेरी मच.